everyone, it's Megan from Kenhub here, and welcome to our tutorial on the arteries of the small intestine. During this tutorial, we will mainly be focusing on the image you can now see in front of you, which is an anterior view of the abdominal cavity. In this image, the abdominal wall and some organs, such as the transverse colon, the pancreas and the stomach, have been dissected away. This has been done to give us a better view of the small intestine and its blood supply. We will start off by looking at a few arteries in this area which don't supply the small intestine. You may wonder why we're doing this, but these arteries are in close proximity to the small intestine, so they're important to know about. The first artery we'll look at is the splenic artery. Here we can see the start of the abdominal aorta after it pierces the diaphragm. The first main artery that branches off the abdominal aorta is the celiac artery, which then gives off three of its own branches. The one branching to the left here is the splenic artery. This artery is the largest branch of the celiac artery, and it supplies the spleen. Hi guys, as you can see, this video is a preview which is reserved to Kenhub Premium members. Why not become one today? As a premium member, you will get access to this video as well as other videos, quizzes, articles, and our Atlas of Human Anatomy, everything you need to learn anatomy in the most fun and efficient way. Join us and let's continue learning together.